Hello our viewers, you're welcome to Ask Dr. Uthman YouTube channel. We would like to thank those of you who have subscribed to our channel, and I promise you that we shall be giving you updates on that channel. We shall be notifying you in case we upload any video. You can ask a question of your choice through our different platform. You can use Facebook, Ask Dr. Uthman. You can use Instagram, you can use Twitter to ask a question of your choice. And today we have a question someone passed through our Facebook channel. She's called Bridget. She's saying, hello Dr. Uthman, I am Bridget from Mutinda. I have a 2-month-old baby and I would like to go for family planning. I wanted this thing they put in the arm, but I hear people say it can move and disappear in the body. Is it true? To our viewers, I think Bridget is trying to mean an implant. And it is not true that an implant can move and disappear in the body. So whoever wants to use an implant, Bridget and other people who would like to use an implant, be rest assured that when you use an implant, it cannot move away from where you put it and do not disappear in the body. It will remain there. But let's first understand what an implant is. An implant is a rod, is a small rod, or you can call it a stick. It's a small stick of around 2 centimeters. It is put underneath, just underneath the skin, below the skin of your arm. And once you put it there, it can help you not to conceive if you are not yet ready to have a child. There are several types of implants, but the commonest, especially in Uganda, we have an Implanon and a Jadel. An Implanon works for 3 years, so you can, if you insert it, you can spend 3 years without conception. And then a Jadel can take you up to 5 years. But when you look at 5 years or 3 years, you may think when you put it, you cannot remove it before that period. However, it's not true. If you put it there, you can remove it, you can take it out at any time of your choice. In other words, you might have put in a Jadel, which is 5 years, but along the way you feel like you want to produce, you're free to remove it, and then you'll be able to conceive. Actually, an implant is a type of a hormonal family planning method. And by saying it's a hormonal family planning method, it means it uses hormones to do the activity it does, or to stop pregnancy. It uses an external hormone which resembles the body hormone. This hormone is called etanegestrel and levonorgestrel. So these two hormones, by hormones I mean hormones are like internal mechanisms that connect different activities. So these hormones, the etanegestrel and levonorgestrel, resemble the body hormone, and the original body hormone is called progesterone. First of all, we should understand how someone gets pregnant. And if you look at the reproductive system, we have the womb, or what we call the uterus. We have the fallopian tubes, and it is the fallopian tubes that connect the uterus to the sac, which contains the eggs. So this sac is called the ovary. So for conception to occur, or for someone to get pregnant, once the sperms are deposited into your body, your private parts, the sperm has to swim through, it has to move, it swims through, it passes through the cervix, it reaches the womb, and then it goes into the fallopian tube. While in the fallopian tube, it will meet an egg which has been moved from the store of the eggs, and that is the ovary, into that area. Then from there, fertilization will occur, and then a baby will form from there, which the baby will be brought back into the womb, and then it will grow from there until you give birth. Now, we want to understand what this, the role of this implant, what Bridget asked, the role of this implant during that process. What this implant does is to thicken the mucus on the cervix. Because we said that the sperms have to pass through that pinhole, the cervical hole, into the womb. So this hormone thickens the mucus within the cervix, and therefore the sperms will not be able to swim through very well to reach their destination. That is the first way. Then the second way is by doing what we call ovulation, or stopping ovulation. What we call ovulation is the movement of the egg, call it the ovum, from the sac or the ovary into the fallopian tube. So this hormone is going to stop the movement of this egg into the fallopian tube, and we call that stopping ovulation. And once ovulation is stopped, it becomes very hard for someone to conceive. At the end of this video, we shall be showing you how we can insert, how this method can be inserted. So it's a simple method. It takes just around 2 to 5 minutes for it to be inserted. So you shouldn't be scared when you're going to insert it, thinking that it's going to be a surgical procedure, they are going to cut you and so on. So it's a simple method, and we are going to be demonstrating to you at the end of this video. But let's first understand the do's and don'ts, all which people are not supposed to use an implant. If you're very fat, obese people, 75 kilograms and above, it is advisable not to use this method. Also, there are some people who have hormonal imbalances. Your doctor told you have issues with your hormones. It may not be good to use this method. There are people who have varicose veins. By varicose veins, we mean those veins, all those blood vessels that develop just behind your calf and around the thighs and so on. If you have those veins, it may not be advisable for you to use an implant. However, you can still go to your doctor and you discuss broadly to undergo examinations and find out if you'll be able to use that method. So this method is good in such a way that it will protect you from getting pregnant up to that period you want, and it can be removed at any time of your choice. However, it has side effects. So our viewers should know that some people get some issues, get some few problems which you need to understand when they use this method. For example, you find a woman telling you that when I put in this implant, I developed bleeding in between my menses. Yeah, it is true that when you use this method, you can have intermenstrual bleeding. So you'll find that someone is bleeding, supposed to bleed once in a month, but is bleeding twice or three times, and you may also find it is heavy bleeding. It can happen with an implant, though it happens in a few people. Also, some people report headache after inserting it. After like 2 to 3 months or a month, they tell you they are having a lot of headache. So it can bring about that. It can bring dizziness. It can bring obesity. You can get big, you develop obesity. It can also lead to mood swings. Someone that is having mood swings, moody every time, it can bring about that. However, some people say, like the person who asked that it moves, it does not move. I would like to mention it absolutely that this implant does not disappear in the body. But what maybe some people perceive to be disappearance from the body is that it may cause obesity in some individuals. So if you put it around here and then someone gets fat, they get obese, you know, there is a tendency of the skin to flap downwards, and so it may be the skin or the body that has extended downwards, and but not the implant going away. So if you fist an expert, you'll be able to locate where that implant is and you'll be able to remove it. So let's demonstrate how we can insert an implant. We have our lady here who already consented for implant insertion. That's her method. She feels she wants to use an implant. After explaining all the side effects and everything, her choice is an implant. Like I told you, an implant looks like this. This is the package of an implant. And currently we are using implant next. It's the one on the current market. So this is an implant we are going to insert. So before we insert it in the area, we said we inserted this implant just under the skin of the upper arm or the arm. So we first clean. We clean the area where we are going to insert it. So after cleaning our area, we are now going to anesthetize. Anesthetizing is killing the pain around that area. So we use a drug which is used to anesthetize or to kill the pain, and right, push it here just above the skin. We call it the subdermal area, so underneath the skin. After giving the anesthesia, we are now sure that there is no, this lady cannot feel pain. She's not going to feel pain, therefore we can now insert the implant. So this is our implant. So here it is. Like I said, it's a very simple procedure. And within no minute, you've already inserted the implant. It's done. It's finished. You insert. Then after. So we are done with fixing an implant or inserting an implant, and she can really be able to feel it. Mama, kafi kauli zewa. Kauli na? Mwekali? Yeah. So she has already felt it. The implant is there, and therefore you can now go and enjoy whatever you want to enjoy and prevent yourself from getting pregnant. Thank you very much. That has been for today. Let's catch up on the next episode. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Ask Dr. Uthman. Bye bye. Ask Dr.